guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day, that's when I walk, oh, that milky white way.
Chariot in the fire. Be still and that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Nay, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Blessedness of tribulation, let us hear the following comforting words. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, these that are arrayed in the white robes, who are they and whence come they? And I said unto him, my Lord, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they that come out of the great tribulation. They washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and they serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall spread his tabernacle over them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun strike upon them, nor any heat, for the Lamb that is in the midst of the throne shall be their shepherd, and shall guide them unto fountains of water of life. And God shall wipe away every tear from their eyes. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I come again and will receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. But we would not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning them asleep. Glory to God, that ye sorrow not, even as the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died, glory to God, and rose again, even so them also that are fallen asleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we that are alive and that are left unto the coming of the Lord shall in no wise precede them that are fallen asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. Glory to God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we that are alive, that are left, shall together with them be caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Glory to God. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall exalt thee. And I heard a voice from heaven saying, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Yea, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their works do follow them. Thou wilt guide me with thy counsel, and afterward receive me to glory. Whom have I in heaven but thee? And there is none upon the earth that I desire besides thee. My flesh and my heart faileth, but God is the strength, hallelujah, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We all shall not sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? The sting death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. For our light affliction, which is for the moment, worketh for us a more exceedingly and eternal weight of glory, while we look not at the things which are seen, the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. And he showed me a river of water of life, bright as crystal, proceeding out of the throne of God and the Lamb in the midst of the street thereof. And on this side of the river and on that was the tree of life, bearing 12 manner of fruit, yielding its fruit every month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nation. And there shall be no curse anymore, and the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be therein, and his servants shall serve him. Shall see his face, and his name shall be upon their forehead, and there shall be night no more. Hallelujah. They need no light of lamp, neither light of sun, for the Lord gave them light, and they reign forever. Naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave, and and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all of this, Job sinned not, neither did he charge God foolishly. The writing of Job says, "For I know my Redeemer lives." Till my change come. Hallelujah. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler, from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come unto thee. Glory to God. I will extol thee, O Lord. Remembrance of his holiness, for his anger endured but a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping, hallelujah, endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. That are alive, that are left worship with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we that are alive and that are remaining shall together with them be caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Glory be. Nay, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, for I am persuaded, hallelujah, that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor death, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is the brokenhearted, and he heals and binds their wound. And one of the elders answered, said unto me, these that are arrayed in their white robe, who are they, and whence came they? And I said unto him, my Lord, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they that come out of the great tribulation, and they washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and they serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall spread his tabernacle over them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Of the throne shall be their shepherd, and shall guide them unto fountains of waters of life. Glory to God. And God shall wipe away every tear from their eyes. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We all shall not sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trump shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Psalms 30:5 says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. Amen. Come on, can we give God a great praise? Amen. Come on, I believe we can do better than that. Come on, let's give God a great praise as we are gathered here on this afternoon to celebrate the life and the legacy of an awesome and a giant. Amen. Come on, those that can, let's celebrate through our hand clapping the life of Deacon James Champion. Come on, let's give him a great round of applause. Hallelujah. We are so thankful to be able, even during these times, the Bible says that in all things that we are to give thanks, for this is the will of the Lord. So even now, with heavy hearts, we still understand that God is yet sovereign and that God is in control. Amen. Amen. Certainly we thank God for all of the men and women of God who are here. Thank God for you, our very own daughter Zion Hope, We thank God for the eulogist of the hour, amen, the nephew of our beloved, amen, Reverend Elvin Mallory, amen. We thank God for you. And to this family, our bereaved family, may God's strength continue to be your portion during this time. Amen. Amen. The family has been so gracious and thoughtful to outline a program, and we want to adhere to that program. Amen. We want them to draw strength from us, but we also want to respect their wishes as they has outlined such an eloquent program. Amen. And at this time, we're going to have a hymn by Deacon Douglas Cutts. After the hymn, we're going to have a prayer. Then we're going to have a song. As your name appear, we ask that you would come. Amen. At this time of hymn.
In time like this, in a time like this, oh, I need the Lord to help me. Touch in a time, come on, y'all, like this, oh, in a time. In a time like this, oh, we all need the Lord, need him to help. I want to say to y'all, just look up. The funeral is over. Deacon Champion attended his funeral. And when I met him, we had so much in common. We both was same age. My birthday was October, and his birthday was December. I want to tell you something funny right here. He would say, he called me on my birthday. I said, hello. He said, hey, Daddy. He said, you older than me. I'm going to call you Daddy. I said, okay. So then when his birthday comes, I call him. And I say, hey, fella, Seems like you done caught up with me. He said, yeah, I met Ryan and caught up with you. He said, but you know one thing? I said, I'm glad I did. But James and I, we done a whole lot of things together. We joined King Solomon Lodge together. And we worked at Lilliston for a long time together. And after that, we drove school bus. 24 years. James, I would see him, and we all were the same every day. And we met two girls, and they was raised like sisters. So they loved one another, and so then we got married, and he had six kids, and God blessed me with six. And we all were raised, and we raised them up here in Smithfield, Georgia. Amen. And we just thank God for meeting up with James Champion. He was my barber. When he first started cutting hair, I told him, I said, I know you can't cut, but come on and learn how on my head. Yes. But we had a whole lot in common. And we loved one another. Never had a word. Never. Every time we saw one another, in church or wherever. Now, James Champion loved this church. Now, he loved this church. I would go get my hair cut sometime, and he wouldn't talk nothing but about this church. Yes. So now, some folks say you're gonna miss him. But I miss him already. When I got the word and Bridges called me, Jesus. But you know, that's something we all gotta do one day, sooner or later. So I'm saying to y'all, just hold your head up high on which come your help. Now, I want y'all to help me sing this hymn. I'm kind of plugged up with sinus, but the funeral is over now, so let's have a good time in the name of the Lord. One thing I know, black people can't sing. They can sing. Yes, sir. They can sing now. So we're going to ask y'all to give us your attention to this hymn. Say, charge to keep our head. A God to glorify. A never dying soul to save and fit it for the sky. Then it said, to serve the present age, my calling to fulfill. Oh, may it all my power engage to do my master's will. It's hard to Yeah. shall you serve the privilege my calling to fulfill. Church, oh Lord, am I praying your amen? Oh Lord, do my master's will. Oh, man. Oh, Lord. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah.
Heavenly Father, we come today, first of all, saying thank you. God, we want to thank you, God, just for allowing us to be here today. God, we do realize that this is a day that we've never seen, nor we'll never see again. And so right now, we want to say thank you. God, as we come here gathered at this homegoing celebration of Brother James Champion, God, we want to thank you for being a champion over all of our lives. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we come gathered here, God, lifting up your name. Because, God, you are worthy of all of the praises. Father God, we know that if you allow this to happen, something good got to come out of it. And in the midst of it all, God, we want to give you the praise and the honor right now. Father God, in Jesus' name, God, we're asking, God, that you allow this experience, God, to allow people to draw closer unto you, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Father God, in Jesus' name, God, we want to say thank you, God. Father God, we want to lift our hands and open our mouths and say thank you, God. Because you've been too good to us. Even in the midst of it all, God, you're still God. You're still King of Kings and you're still Lord of Lords, God. And for that alone, we want to say thank you, God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, you are a strong tower, God. And we want to say thank you, God. Father God, you are a wheel in the middle of a wheel, God. And we want to say thank you right now. Father God, in Jesus' name, God, we're asking, God, that you just grant strength to the family, God. drank strength to the sisters, the brothers, God, the children, the grandchildren, God, and the friends and friends alike, God, because you know, God, that we know that you have all power, God, in the name of Jesus, God. And God, I just want to just say thank you, God, because even in the midst of it all, God, I know that you are able to do all things, God. I know that you're able, God, to grant strength. I know that you're able, God, to be a comforter. I know that you're able to be a heart fixer and a mind regulator, God. And somebody's heart need fixing right now. Somebody's heart need regulating right now, God. And somebody needs you to color them in your bosom in the name of Jesus, God. Father God, we're thanking you right now, God. Father God, let the enemy, God, let the enemy, God, know that you are the one, God, who reigns all power. In the name of Jesus. God, we ask you right now that you move mightily right now, God. We ask you that you touch each and every heart right now, God. Father God, this is a homegrown celebration, God, and your people should be celebrating in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, God, we lift you up right now and we magnify your name because you are worthy of all the praises. And God, a lot of people may not understand what's going on. A lot of people's faith is being eclipsed by the troubles. A lot of people's understanding, God, is not being understood, God. But God, in the name of Jesus, God, bring about understanding to your people. Father God, Brother James lived for a long time, God. You only promised us 70 years, God, but you gave him more. And we say thank you, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you right now. In the name of Jesus, God. Have your way in this place, oh God. Have your way in this place. Bless the man that's going to bring the word. In the name of Jesus. Give him preaching power and a spiritual imagination just to make it plain to your people. And God, we thank you, God, for what you're about to do in this homegoing celebration. We thank you for what you're about to do, God, in the lives of your people, God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we count it all joy. In the mighty, majestic name of Jesus, we do pray. And the people of God said, amen, amen, amen. I dare about two or three of y'all just to give God some praise in this place. Let me tell you something. This is the time that you should be celebrating. Now, if God had done anything to you, you just keep your mouth closed. But I'm talking to somebody that know God has woke you up this morning. I'm talking to somebody that's happy that God gave you life, health, and strength. Now if you're going through some stuff and God ain't did nothing to you, just close your mouth and just sit there. But I'm talking to somebody that know God done made a way for you. God done did some things for you that only God could do. I need for those folks to give God some praise. I need about two or three of y'all just to stand to your feet right now and tell God thank you. If God did something for you, tell him thank you right now. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 Amen. And amen. Let me tell you something before I go to see. Let me tell you something. My Uncle James, let me tell you something. He have touched many lives. But guess what? God touched more lives. Y'all missed that one. Let me tell you something. One of these days, we're going to be in this very spot. One of these days, our time is going to come. Listen, last March, guess what? His sister was eulogized, which is my mama. So let me tell you something. We are not here to stay. We are going to leave this place one day. So this is the time to start getting yourself in order. If you ain't got it right now, this is the time you need to start. Amen.
Amen. To God be the for the things that he is doing. We certainly thank God for Deacon Cuts. Amen. For that amazing hymn. Amen. And prayer by Pastor Yaz Johnson. Amen. Before we sing, it's been an honor for me, family, to have been Deacon Champion's pastor for the last 3 months. And I told the people last Sunday that it does not take a long time for someone to make an impact on your life. And I am so humbled and thankful to God that he allowed Deacon Champion's and I's path to cross. And I had to pull out a paisley tie for Deke today, because Deke could wear them ties. And he would be sharp on Sundays. And his smile would be radiant. And he believed in a young pastor. He would push me and he would encourage me. And that means a lot. But I began to think, and he told me how he drove the school buses. And I shared with him, I said, yeah. I said, Deke, I drive too. He said, what? You don't drive no bus. I said, yes, sir. And I started thinking the other day about transportation and how on certain buses they put a monitor on the bus. Okay. And the purpose of the monitor is to ensure that the behavior of the kids don't distract that of the driver. And I was praying the other day just for the family, and God just gave me this crazy revelation. He said, I need you just to encourage them. That's what really happened on the other day, as Grace was the driver.
Come on, man.
But there was a monitor on bus 89 on this side called Mercy. And when they hire you as a driver, they tell you that your number one priority is to make sure that the students get home safe. Sister Bridget, to the rest of the family, I want you guys to know that that's what took place on last Sunday morning. Grace and Mercy had one more assignment. They had a student by the name of James Champion who they had to transport one more time. They had one job, and that was to make sure that he made it home safely. So we celebrate his life, and we celebrate the true meaning of the heart of a champion. Amen. Now, it is not quite Sunday, but I need y'all to act like it's Sunday for the next 35 seconds and give God the greatest praise you can. Deacon Chaplin used to like this song. We're going to lift it and we're going to get out of the way. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know the storm. Let's have a little church. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, you know the storm is past. That's it. Yes, sir. Yeah. Like it's Sunday morning. Yeah, hallelujah. Yeah, hallelujah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Lordy. Oh, Lordy. You know the storm. You know.
got to move forward. One more. Oh, won't it be grand, oh Lord? Yes, sir. Sing it, won't it be grand? Oh, won't it be? Oh, I'm going home to live with you. Yes, sir. Won't it be grand? You can hinder me, but you cannot. Oh, the God I serve, he's gonna answer prayer.
To be able to honor such a man with an outstanding life. And we thank God. We're going to continue with our Old Testament scripture, Reverend Daryl K. Champion. Then we're going to have our New Testament scripture from Pastor Craig Champion. Amen. Let's hear them at this time.
Amen, everyone. Amen. This is a beautiful homegoing celebration. Amen. To my cousins, I want you all to know that I love you all dearly. My early beginnings of knowing what a church was began right here at this church as a little bitty type. And I have so many fond memories here, as well as homegoing celebrations. Amen. But I want you all to know, who may not be related to the Champion family, that we consider you all to be family. We have a motto within our family: the family that prays together stays together. Amen. And I tell you, I remember as a young child, probably when I first began to speak, my family, which is part of this family, taught me a prayer. And it goes like this: now I lay me down to sleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Amen. But also I know that our Heavenly Father, he gave us a prayer. So from Old Testament reading, I'll share this with you, and I pray that it gives you comfort on this day. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will hear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou present a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
From all of my labors over yonder where Jesus is.
Amen. Uncle James gave me my first haircut. And I would come over to his house with Granddaddy and sit there and listen to them talk. One day when I moved back to Albany, I had bought a Harley Davidson motorcycle. And I called myself riding around. Where did I end up? Uncle James' house. And he was working on his tractor. Family, we love you. Uncle James will be missed. But know that he is with the Father. Know that he loved each and every one of you from the bottom of his heart, his whole heart. Our Old Testament reading comes from the book of Revelation, chapter 21. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Hallelujah. God bless you, family, at this time. We pray you find solace in the Word of God.
Amen. Amen. This time's program calls for 2-minute reflections. We want to adhere to the family's request during this time and honor those 2 minutes. Amen. Amen. We're going to have first Evangelist Sarah Dice of Zion Hope Baptist Church, followed by Murtis Champion Jones, Dibb County School Board, and then Lawrence Gay, New Hope.
Amen. Truly we give God the honor, the glory, and the praise on this beautiful, wonderful day. We thank him for our Lord and Savior who has allowed us to come together. And although we feel in our hearts it may be a sad occasion, but this is a great day because we stand to witness the walk of this man's life, Deacon James Champion. Someone that I met when I came to Zion Hope, and God gave me the privilege to serve under him for 11 years. So much wisdom he gave out, so much advice, and he didn't just talk it, he walked it. I saw in this man, he stood for what was right. He stood when it was bad, he stood when it was good, he stood through the ups, he stood through the downs. He walked the walk that every Christian gonna have to walk. We can't do it, 99.5 just ain't gonna get it. He showed us how to do it. He showed us how to get there. And I'm not trying to put him in heaven. He's already lived there. He's already lived his obituary. So I just thank God today for this family that I met through Sister Bridget, who is more than a friend to me. I consider a sister. And when I met her family. I met a beautiful group of people who welcome you with open arms and just showed you nothing but love. And I knew where it came from. because that's how Deacon Champion was. I speak on his behalf today that this was a dynamic servant of God. I didn't say he was perfect. I say he was a dynamic servant of God. And his walk in this life pleased God. He loved his church, and he did whatever he had to do to make sure the church kept running righteously. And we thank God for that today. So family, lift up your head, O ye gates, and the King of Glory shall come in.
She's the family's mom. James told me one time I got ready to have a family reunion in Smithfield. He said, you better see Ma. Ma take care of all the business, so thank you, Ma. I thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak some words about our brother and about the children's daddy on behalf of the Elder and Genuinely Champion family. Now, I am Mertis, and I am child number 11. Now, when Carolyn gets up here, she's going to make sure you know she's the baby. I'm number 11 of the Elder and Jimmy Champion family of the Champion Clan of Smithfield, Georgia. And I want to talk about my brother, who was the fourth child of us 12 children of Elder and Jimmy Lee. James, affectionately called Bud Lewis by mom and daddy, was the oldest living champion in the whole Champion family clan of Doc Champion Sr., our granddaddy. Now James was a take charge man, as you heard my sister over here say. He was a take charge man. And for that reason, Daddy left him in charge of Mama, the remaining 10 children, the farm, after his death in 1980. Now James took care of our mother, as well as his own wife and children. He was our go-to man. As a child, he gave me a nickname. My nickname, y'all better not call me this, but I'm gonna take the term and tell you what it was. It's Bruh Rat. I could never leave. Hey, Gloria. I could never lose that name. Until the day that James went home, he was calling me Bruh Rat. James became a businessman at a very young age. His first business was bottoming chairs for the family and the neighbors. He bought them enough chairs to save up $125. And that was a lot of money during that time, as a teenager, to purchase what he called his Cadillac bicycle. Now, many of you probably didn't know that James made black history right here in the Sumter City community. James drove the Sumter City, he drove the first school bus. Now, I know y'all think Uncle Doc was the one that drove the first school bus, but James drove the first school bus for the, what they call the colored children in the Sumter County community at the age of 15. Now, his bus was our daddy's pickup truck. For the Sumter County School Board made him a yellow cab to be placed on the back of daddy's truck to pick up the high school students in the area because they had no bus for us colored children in America. So those who wanted to attend Stanley A.S. High School, the Board of Education paid James a whole $25 a month to transport those students to America's. James was the family's decision maker and advisor. When we needed an answer, we'd go to James, and he would give us one. And he'd give us good advice on buying cars. And in fact, James put me in my first Cadillac. Y'all who know James know what he likes to drive. He gave us advice on buying a home. I can't see. And even choosing a mate. Now one day at the family reunion, James had met my friend, Al. And he said, "Murders, I want to see you." I said, "Oh, Lord, I got in trouble with James." I said, "Yes, sir? What is it, James?" He said, "I got something I want to tell you." I said, "What you want to tell me?" He said, "I like Brother Al." He said, "I want to tell you, picked a good one. And I want you to keep him." And I kept him. Okay. He supported this family. And he loved the family activities, especially the Champion Family Reunion. He supported me in all my activities down this way. He attended my class reunions. When I was the president for the Georgia Retired Educators, and I told James that I was going to come to Lee County to speak to the retired educators, he said, "I'll be there." And he was there. He loved and supported his children and his grandchildren. He wanted all of them to become productive citizens in their community and in the church. And they accomplished that. He was a great and God-fearing man and a deacon of Zion Hope for 52 years. And a member of this church for 75 years. And I believe he probably, Pastor, one of the longest standing members in the church. Y'all need to do a little history on that. But I believe James is the longest standing member in the church. He always wanted to do right by Zion Hope and the people of this community. He would often discuss with me how he felt about Zion Hope and his love for his members. He took his position as a deacon of this church very seriously. And he allowed God to lead him with his decision makings. He was a great God-fearing man, a man of wisdom. And we loved him very dearly. He will be sorely missed. Now, Ma Bridget, your daddy is leaving his family in your hands and the other children's hands. But since you the ma, you know what you got to do. Amen. All right. I thank y'all so very much.
How y'all doing? I got to say a few words about my friend and my brother. The Bible tells that some friends will come close to them. And I think that's the way that we are. I have a little history on us, with my friend, then James and some other fellows who had passed it on. When we started out going to America, me and James Homer, Dude, James Mother, James Hobbs, Adam, my brother. And we went to America quite a bit. I can't even tell you now how long, but I made it 10, 15 years. I used to go up there. That was every night. We didn't have no car, so James, he had a car. He would always pick us up. Well, now at night, but he would come by and pick me and my brother and other guys up. And we would go to America, you know, have fun and different things like that. But all those guys are gone now. I was talking to Chaplain not 2 months ago. And I was talking about what's going on right now. Death. But we didn't have, in our mind, the idea that, you know, these things happen. But they do happen. We didn't know at the time when we was talking that, you know, this was going to happen. But all those guys, not except me and my brother, I think is going on. James was one of the best friends I ever had. And he kept me out of a lot of trouble in those days because I think I was kind of crazy a little bit. And I would get into a lot of things. He would stop me. It's hard on me to be here because we used to plan, talk to one another about when these days come like this, that I'll be there, wherever you at. I'll be there. We talked about that a couple of months ago. So I'm just kind of hating. But I thank God that I'm here. And I just really, sometimes you don't know what to say because you don't know where life's going to end at. But you all are here, and I thank God to see all of y'all. And I thank y'all for being here. But I love the champ. He was a real good friend. I tell you how good a friend he was. He had a brand new pony I just bought. And I went to Mercury. We had signs and different things at that time that you need a car, so bring a sign. So this will tell you a lot about James that you heard people say this or that. Before the night was over, we was dancing on the floor, and I did it like that. The key hit my hand. Yeah, just had a brand new car, so that should tell you a lot about you. I just don't know. I could go on and on and on, but I see that. Thank you.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have the reading of the obituary, and we're going to have a solo by Carolyn Champion Mallory. After the solo, we're going to hear from heaven, amen, as we will hear the eulogy from Pastor Evan J. Mallory Sr., amen. Thank you.
everybody. Thank you so much for coming to say goodbye to my brother, my last brother. I know you love him. I love him so much. My brother James Edward, Champion Senior. When we were back in July, was it a year ago, a couple of years ago, at one of my other brothers' viewing, I reached back to him. I say, you know, we're depending on you to keep the family together. He said, I'm going to do the best I can. I said, you know what, you were already keeping the family together. And that's what he's been doing for a number of years, keeping the family together. I had a special kind of love for my brother James. And I'm not going to talk very much, as I'm still recovering from that old big C too. But God is able. He's truly able. Do you know that God is able? Surely he is. He's able to see us through. Hallelujah. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in my God.
To depend upon his word. in Jesus.
I've learned to trust in my God
through it all. Through it all, through the pain
and sorrow,
through it all.
But God has given some good times, some real good times. I've learned to depend upon His word. Oh, I've learned to depend upon His word. Now He's present with Him. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And the children of God said, amen, amen. To my family. I'm during this loss, amen, of an awesome man, awesome father, awesome husband, awesome deacon, awesome granddaddy, awesome sir, everything he did, he was good at. Amen. So I'm honored to call him uncle. Amen. We had the opportunity of four uncles, and all four of my uncles were barbers. Amen. I even followed in the footsteps and took on, because I would see them. They were so debonair. We used to meet up at Uncle James' house, and some of my cousins, we would watch it. And we noticed that all of our uncles, they would wear, you know, they had their own style, but they would have their fedoras and they'd have their jewelry. And I wanted it to be like that. Amen. I'd look out and see my cousins, amen, with their fedoras and debonair. Amen. We just thank that for that legacy of being excellent. Amen. This continues to pass on through generation to generation. I want to sing a piece of this song. Amen. And then it'll be preaching time. I've had some good days, and I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and some sleepless nights, but when I looked around and I think things over, all of my good days outweighed my bad days, and I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low, I can barely see the road. I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? But He knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes can't see. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord. Anybody got a thank you, Lord, this evening? Thank you, Lord. And I won't complain. You know why? Because God been good to me. Has it been good to you? He
me. More than this whole world could ever be. He's been so good to me. He dried every one of my tears away. Changed my midnight into day. So instead of complaining, I'll just say, thank you, Lord. It may seem hard right now, but I'll just say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I won't complain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a word from the Lord. We'll look at 2 Samuel chapter 5. 2 Samuel chapter 5. Amen. The life that Deacon James Champion live is already spoken for him. And so my assignment on today is to preach to the living. My assignment today is to encourage. My assignment today is those that may not know the Lord as there's Christ, as the Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior, that this is an opportunity for you. Amen. The word of God says in 2 Samuel chapter 5 verse 17, but when the Philistines heard that they had anointed David king over Israel, all of the Philistines came out to seek David. And David and his men heard of it. And he asked them, he said, and David inquired the Lord, saying, shall I go up to the Philistines? Wilt thou deliver them into my hand? And he said, go up, for I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into thy hand. And David came to Baal-perazim, and David and his men burnt the images there. And they said, the Lord had broken forth upon my enemies before me as the breach of waters. Therefore they call that name Baal-perazim. And there they left their images, and David and his men burned them. And the Philistines came up yet again and spread themselves in the valley. And David inquired, saying, he said, thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass and come behind them and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. Amen. If we had to give a topic or title, it would simply be, the Lord is fighting my battles. The Lord is fighting my battles. Here it is. David has been appointed. David has been promoted. David has been placed in a position that now people realize that he has become king over all of Israel. And in him becoming king over all of Israel, we discover that anytime there is a promotion, that everybody that's there is not a well-wisher. Sometimes during seasons of promotion, there are simply people there to be nosy. Sometimes during seasons of promotions, we discover that there are people that are genuinely there to celebrate with you. And sometimes in seasons of promotions, that people don't ever want you to live past your past. You know, there's always some people that remember what you used to be. There always are some people that can look back and remember when the days of Junebug and Mang Mang. They can remember you before in your BC days, before you knew the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And what happens is that now they see Brother David here in this valley. They see David here being appointed. They see David being anointed. And they came out to fight with David. And David asked the Lord, he said, Lord, shall I go up? Wilt thou deliver these Philistines into my hand? And David says, and the Lord says unto David, go up. Now, the interesting thing is that David is anointed, David is appointed by God, but he still had the spirit of humility and allowed God to order his steps. And I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but listen, that even in tedious times, even in troublesome times, even in hard times, listen, allow God to order your step. The word of God tells us, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him. That means whether you're doing right or wrong, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he'll direct your path. When you can't see your way through, God has a way of directing and ordering our steps. And so here it is, the enemy comes up yet again. The Bible declares that in 22, and the Philistines came up yet again and spread themselves. We understand that the devil comes up many times. He comes up over and over and over again. If he can't beat you one way, he'll try to get you another way. If he can't attack your health, he'll try to attack your mind. If he can't attack your mind, he'll try to attack your family. If he can't attack the family, he'll attack on the job. If he can't attack on the job, he'll attack in the community. The devil tries things over and over and over. But I want to submit to you that, listen, that after
we've shed our tears, after we finish crying, listen, we've got a work to do. We have an assignment to do, because we've got to stand in this gap that this great man was standing in. We've got to stand in this gap and now bridge the gap. Listen, we've got to love even greater. We've got to push and promote and be a backbone to our families even greater than before. We've got to stand. Listen, we got to stand and pray. They said that cousin Bridget gonna be more, but listen, everybody got to step up and pray and connect. Like, listen, we got to drop that stuff. We got to connect like never before, because when a link in a chain is missing, then that means that we got to connect closer. That means that now we got to start reaching out even more than times like this. We got to start reaching out more than times of failure. Sometimes we just got to call and see how each other doing. So listen, if y'all start getting some calls from me, it's because I love you. I hadn't heard from you, and I love you, and I want to connect in love. So listen, the enemy calls up yet again. He says, thou shall not go up. God gives a different set of instructions and tells them to fetch a compass behind them and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. In other words, what he tells them is that I don't want you to do a thing. I just want you to be still and let God, and I'm going to fight your battles. And that's what I want to say right there parenthetically this evening, is that we've got to learn to stand still, pray, and watch God fight our battles. If we stand still and pray, watch this. God has a way of moving things out of our way. God has a way of moving obstacles, moving hindrances, moving hardships, moving things out of our way, because he said, that if we declare his word, if we're believing in his word, if we're trusting in him, that all the former things, all those old things, all those blockages shall pass away. He says, they require the Lord. He said, thou shalt not go up. Fetch a compass behind them. Come upon them over against the mulberry trees, and let it be when thou hearest a sound in the goings of the tops of the mulberry tree. But we understand that mulberry tree is no way that the mulberry tree can make a sound. It's scientifically impossible that it cannot. It does not have vocal cords. It does not have a mouth. How can mulberry trees make a sound? And what I realize is that it's just like this wind blowing. That as the wind blows and the trees begin to sway, that the leaves rustle with one another and they begin to make a sound, because the leaves are wrestling. The branch, the wind is blowing the trees. The trees are manipulating the limbs. The limbs manipulating the leaves, and the leaves are wrestling. So it suggests that as the leaves and the limbs rustle against each other, it makes a noise. I'm going to say it this way. It suggests that the leaves are slapping fire with one another. It suggests that the leaves are in agreement, because God has already worked it out, because he said, when thou hearest a sound. In other words, when you see the leaves wrestling, when you hear a sound, that I've already worked it out. So I don't know who I'm talking to in here, but there's been some things you've been praying about. There have been some things that have been weighing you down. God is saying in the spirit that I've already worked it out. He said, and thou shalt bestir thyself, for then shall the Lord go out before thee to smite the host of the Philistines. In other words, the Lord goes out before us. So after we've shed our tears, after we've finished crying, after we've gone through this, and after we've gone through, now it's time for the family to come together and pray like never before. I remind of a story as I close about a little boy. And the little boy got on a new bus, and his new bus was bus 89. And when he got on the bus, he went up to the bus driver and gave the bus driver a piece of paper, the little piece of paper. And the bus driver read it and looked at him funny and dropped him off. On the second day, the boy gives the bus driver a piece of paper. The bus driver reads the piece of paper, looks at the little boy funny, and drops him off. On the third day, he looks at the bus driver and gives the bus driver a piece of paper. And finally, the bus driver looks at the little boy and said, Monday, I read this paper and dropped you off. The second day, I dropped you off. But on this third day, I've got to ask, why is it that I have to drop you off here? Well, on the other side of the paper, it said, "Dear Mr. Bus Driver, please drop my son off at the graveyard." Every day for them 3 days, the little boy had been getting dropped off at the graveyard. And what the little boy did, he said, "Mr. Bus Driver, if you come down and look a minute." And the bus driver stepped down the steps and looked. He said, "On the other side of the graveyard is my father's house." In other words, the graveyard is just a shortcut to daddy's house. And what I'm trying to tell somebody is that we all have to take that shortcut one day to get to daddy's house. We all have to get off, y'all, at that bus stop. And when I get to that time where I have to get off at that bus stop, I want to have my house in order. And so we got to start looking around and sweeping around our own doors. We got to start loving one another like never before. And when that time comes, I want to be like my uncle, and I want to hear him say, "Servant, well done." I used to hear old church say, "Servant, well done. Well done, thy good and faithful servant." But I want to hear him declare me as a friend. I want him to say that I've done what I was supposed to do. I've loved who I was supposed to love. I've helped who I was supposed to help. I'm a champion. And it's more than a name, but it's a bloodline. We are champions. And so we're going to exemplify that champion love, that champion swagger, that champion mark of excellence. In all that we do, let's continue to be the best. Family, I love you, but God loves you best. God bless you.
Come on, let's give the man of God another great hand. Amen. God is fighting my battles. And family, I just believe that God is fighting on your behalf even during this time. Amen. We thank Pastor Mallory for an awesome word of God on today. And at this time, we're going to have our acknowledgments and presentation from the J.W. Williams Funeral Home staff. Amen. Amen.
The resolutions have been sent to the family. With deepest sympathy, love Pam and family. We are so sorry for the loss of your dad. God will always give you strength and comfort. With deepest sympathy, we love you all, the Spark family. With deepest sympathy, City of Smithville, Mayor, City Council, and employees. With deepest sympathy, Dr. Renee Mays, Ms. Rosemary Jones, faculty and staff of Sumter County Primary School. In loving memory, may the warm and fond memories of Champ comfort you and live in your hearts forever. Love you, James and Charlotte Walker, Dickie Claudia Walker, Gardena, California. With deepest sympathy, Mary Lee Johnson, Luana Johnson. With deepest sympathy, Mr. and Mrs. AJ Daniel and family. With deepest sympathy, Jerusalem Grove Baptist Church, Reverend Ricky Clad, Pastor. We are praying for you, love the clique. Our beloved bus driver, James Champion, Carrie Mosley, Mary French, Mamie Moses, Maddie Williams, Mary Chambers, and Robert Adams. With deepest sympathy, Zion Hope Baptist Church, Reverend Horace Holloway III, Pastor. Resolution has been sent to the family, Whole Truth International. Deacon James Champion, a brother, father, grandfather, and friend, no matter what your trials are or how big your mountains seem, the Lord is there to see you through. He'll go through all extremes. So if your cross seems hard to bear and you know not what to do, the one who loves you most of all will be there to see you through. We are placed in this world for a limited time, and with the breath of the infant begins the race to the grave, a race everyone must run. Whereas in the providence of God, he has brought to the close of this life Deacon James Champion, the officers and members of Whole Truth International Ministries in Americus, Georgia, feel that it is befitting to express our sincere sympathy to the family during the passing of Deacon James Champion Sr. We commend him who knoweth best and will always do right. You have our sincere prayers. Whereas we, the congregation of the Whole Truth International Ministries, do offer our sincere sympathy. Your sorrow is our sorrow. Your loss is magnified by the loss of a dear soul from the Champion family. Be it resolved that the family weep, not as those who have no hope, remembering that you must continue on in spite of Deacon Champion's absence. Be it resolved that we bow in humble submission to him who never makes a mistake, and remind the family to be encouraged by remembering the poem above. At this time, we are pleased to make a special presentation on behalf of the Lee County Living Legends to the family of the late Deacon James Edward Champion Sr. We, the committee of the Lee County Living Legends, organized in 2013, send you words of comfort. We were humbled to have you in our presence at the annual event. It is with great pleasure and honor to present to this family the following plaque to show our appreciation. Your committee, Dr. Gwendolyn West, and the committee to honor our living legends, Leesburg, Georgia. Given love and memory of a loving and caring father, grandfather, brother, and friend from the family. In love and memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. And finally, we present this pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared as a family. For anyone that has ever loved is never lost. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.
Amen. At this time, we're going to prepare for our committal services. For as much as it has pleased the Almighty God to remove out of his wise providence the soul of our deceased and our beloved Deacon James Champion, we now therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, looking forward to the general resurrection in which the last trump shall sound, and we shall all be caught up in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Amen.
Son Jesus, that we can pray.